Welcome to beautiful Brussels. Waffle shops, chocolate shops, chocolate shops, and waffle shops. Belgium, the land of delicious foods. Now we come to the grand place. The name. Quite a beautiful square. Great square just to hang out in and mingle in. Lots of food selections. It's looking amazing. Architecture. Smells really nice too. Smells like waffle cones. It's definitely some kind of good food. Shadows over here. Is this view perhaps a bit better? It's just a nice square though. All directions. Grand Place seems like a very, very appropriate name.
They're right.
Yeah.
here in the square having their dinner. This is inside the town hall. Yeah. Ground place market is straight through those doors over there. I just came through. Just a little courtyard in the middle here. People to small girls to old men. It's really, really a weird thing to me. And probably the least exciting famous site I've ever seen. But yeah. So yeah.
With that, we also give them the
now reached the beautiful Brussels Cathedral of Saint Michel. Let's see if it's up on the hill. Above the park, we go straight downhill. So, through the towers. It's very much in the style of Westminster Abbey and Notre Dame. Some beautiful cathedral has hardly anybody. Everybody's crowded around the little boy peeing fountain thing. This is much more interesting. Look at that bad boy. Ooh. Back of the cathedral here. Just keeps going up and up and up the hill. Right now walking through Brussels Park, or Parc des Bruxelles, and on my way to the Royal Palace. We're almost there. A lot of hills going up. Nice big square park. Coming out of the park, we arrive at the Royal Palace. Grand place as they're taking down the market, and the sun is getting a little better, not so much in our face here. Town hall in front, all these buildings are so beautiful. Finally, we will finish our visit to Brussels at the Atomium, which is designed to look like an atom, and it was built for the 1958 World's Fair. And I was thinking of the 1962 World's Fair, that's a space needle. 1958 World's Fair. And it is considered probably the symbol of Brussels, a landmark that's recognized around the world. It is definitely an interesting and unusual building. And you can go inside those domes and whatever you want to call them, spheres, walk from one to the next. I'm here early in the morning before anybody else is here, so it's not open yet, but I have to catch a train. But there you have it. Fascinating, you can see the whole reflection in them. But yeah, it doesn't open up for a couple more hours. Here we are, a bit closer here. It is an interesting contraption, a giant atom. Keep flying behind it. Staircases on each side going up to this first one here. there, then they got the gate locked. Interesting, huh? Well, there you have it. It's a fairly interesting little thing. Big thing, you want to call it? Giant atom. Chalker's just getting going now. This thing is weird. It's in the middle of like a big park area, which I guess was obviously made off for the 58 World's Fair. But kind of nice, a lot of trees and stuff. Good paths for joggers. Gives you an interesting angle though with it rising above the trees there. Well, I think that's about it for Brussels here. My big regret is that I didn't have a chance to see the Chocolate Museum in Brussels. I've been to the Louvre in Paris, and I've been to the Metropolitan in New York, and I've been to the Hermitage in St. Petersburg, Russia, and I've been to the Smithsonian, and I've been to the Egyptian Museum in Cairo, but the Chocolate Museum in Brussels is going to have to rank right up there with the Potato Museum that I went to in Idaho as the real great museums in the world, I would think. No, but I really did think that would be interesting to see.